But before that, we're going to have a dancer. Delegate number one, Mr. Dominica Jovan John Baptiste. Gentlemen, put your hands together for Mr. Dominica.
Now let's welcome delegate number two, Mr. U.S. Virgin Islands, Christopher Rivera.
I don't want to be alone tonight. It's pretty clear that I'm not over you. I'm still thinking about the things you do. So I don't want to be.
In his GQ wear entitled The Prophecy.
Dancing with a stranger.
gentlemen, put your hands together for Mr. USVI.
Let's welcome delegate number 3, Mr. St. Kitts and Nevis, Jonah Valeri.
Evening wear piece entitled Debonair. Gentlemen, let's welcome on stage delegate number 4, Mr. Barbados, Carlos Yearwood.
I don't wanna be alone.
amen. Put your hands together for Mr. Barbados.
And now let's welcome delegate number 5, Mr. St. Martin, Larry Wong.
GQ Wear entitled Midnight Magic. Gentlemen, put your hands together for Mr. St. Martin. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome on stage delegate number 6, Mr. Antigua and Barbuda, Raynor Sharp. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Mr. Antigua and Barbuda. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to welcome all six delegates back on stage.
Starting with contestant number one, Mr. Dominica.
Closely followed by Mr. USVI. Mr. Barbados.
Mr. St. Martin.
And finally, Mr. Antigua and Barbuda. Judges will be awarding 35 points for appearance, which comprises of being well-groomed, originality, style, and fit, whether the participant is dapper. Presentation, 15 points, which comprises of creativity, confidence, upright posture, smooth walk, and clean turns. So our gentlemen will be called on stage to participate in the interview segment. And we'll be starting with Mr. Dominica. He will select a question from the box.
All right, we're ready to start the interview segment, but before we do, I just want to ask the audience, when the contestants are giving their answers, kindly respect them and be silent until they're finished. This is can be a very terrifying experience, so anything can distract them, so we're just asking you to respect that, okay? Mr. Dominica, good night. How are you doing?
I'm doing fine, and you?
Doing good.
Awesome.
All right, so your warm-up question. How have the girls in Nevis been treating you?
I must say, going to the Soca Monarch and meeting the lovely ladies in Nevis, it was awesome.
Great, great, great. All right, so I have your question box here. You're going to open it and select one of the items inside. And then I'll read it to you. All right, so your question this evening, Mr. Dominica. Some Caribbean genres of music, such as dancehall, have been accused of promoting violence. In your opinion, what can be done by artists in these genres to combat violence in the region? I repeat, some Caribbean genres of music, such as dancehall, have been accused of promoting violence. in your opinion, what can be done by artists in these genres to combat violence in the region?
Firstly, I would like to say we need to understand first the music from the different islands. Understand where they come from, understand their style, understand the beat. Because one of the mindsets of people is that when we hear of, let's say, dancehall or any other music from different islands, we tend to think of, okay, it's not our style, so we tend to have a negative connotation to it. But what I would say to dancehall artists to try to prevent or try to block that negative connotation is educate. Ensure that you let people know about the music. Try also to refrain from using negative wordings and negative actions, basically, in the songs.
Thank you, Mr. Dominique.
Now we welcome on stage Mr. USVI, delegate number 2.
All right, Mr. Christopher Rivera, my question to you is, how do you pull your Nipsey Hussle look out?
So it's funny because my picture got posted up for the show. That was the first time I actually heard that I look like Nipsey Hussle. On top of that, they started posting up an actual picture of him in a burgundy outfit with kind of a similar pose. And I was like, okay, I can see resemblance. I can see where they get the beard and the facial features. But, I mean, it's a great thing. He was a great legend. He did a lot for the community in California and above. And as well, so his passing is just a blessing on top of everything else, even though it was a loss.
All right. Thank you so much. Now that you're relaxed, I'm going to ask you to select your question from the box.
Sure.
All right, Mr. Rivera, your question this evening, I will repeat it. A friend has indicated to you that having unprotected sex with a virgin can cure any sexually transmitted infection. What would you say to your friend to dispel this misinformation? A friend has indicated to you that having unprotected sex with a virgin can cure any sexually transmitted infection. What would you say to your friend to dispel this misinformation?
That's a great question. So being an activist in the HIV world, in the HIV platform for over 15 years, we must know that first way of protecting yourself is abstinence. That's the number one way to protect yourself, regardless if somebody's a virgin or not. You don't know what they could be doing. They could be lying to you. They cannot be telling you the truth. They could be sleeping behind your back. So with that being said, protection. Besides abstinence, protection is the number one way to protect yourself. On top of that, there's also other methods as far as protection. There's a pill called PrEP. You take that once a day, every day, and it actually eliminates the risk of you contracting HIV or AIDS. So with that being said, yes, really, yeah, really, really, yeah. So there's one called PrEP, and then there's one called NPEP. NPEP, you take it within 24 hours if you feel like you've been infected by someone. And then other than that, you just have to be HIV negative to be on PrEP. You can get it from your medical doctors. And it's also something that is not really seen in the Caribbean islands. And I really feel like we should implement it within all of our Caribbean islands, within the region, and also implement different mobile units to come out and do random testing for those that want to know their knowledge and wants to get tested. That's the only way you can go about it. So with that being said, abstinence is the number one way. Other than that, use protection. If not, get on PrEP and call it a day. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. St. Croix.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome on stage delegate number 3, Mr. St. Kitts and Nevis, Jonah Valerie.
Good night, Mr. Valerie. How are you doing?
I'm doing awesome. So how are you all people doing?
Awesome, awesome. Okay, so what's this stick about?
It's actually a cane. And it's to help me stand straight. Yeah.
That's a lot of
All right. I see you're a bit of a kiddo. Okay, Mr. Valerie, I'm going to let you select your question from the box. I will read it, repeat it, okay? Your question goes, many young men in the Caribbean do not finish high school or seek to attain a college degree. What would you say to these men about the importance of earning an education? I repeat, many young men in the Caribbean do not finish high school or seek to attain a college degree. What would you say to these men about the importance of earning an education?
Being a proud young man and a proud father, my advice to young men is that education is the new sexy. Gangster, no. So my advice to young men is to stay in school. Get that education so that you can educate your children and educate your friends around you. Because with education, that is the new wealth. Thank you.
All right, Mr. Valerie. Thank you. Mr. Sankits and Nevis.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome on stage delegate number 4, Mr. Barbados, Carlos Yearwood.
Good evening, Mr. Yearwood. How are you doing?
Good evening, sir. I'm doing pretty well. Was nervous at first, but the audience has made me relax with your presence and your responses. Like, I truly do appreciate you all.
All right. A lot of people don't know that you're a designer. Tell us a little bit more about that.
I designed actually all the pieces that I've showcased here tonight. I did not create all of them, but I did have a hand in creating all of them. And I do like the idea of design because it is an expression that you don't get very often. And through very many things. And I appreciate the ability to create and not just do. Thank you very much. Amazon.com.
All right, Mr. Yearwood, I'm gonna now allow you to select your question. I will repeat it to you twice. Male pageantry is on the rise in the Caribbean. In your experience, what are the effects of male pageantry on character development? I repeat, male pageantry is on the rise in the Caribbean. In your experience, what are the effects of male pageantry on character development?
Ladies and gentlemen, poise, articulation, expression, time management. These are but a few things you learn on your experience in pageantry. Male pageantry is on the rise, and I suggest that it go further, that more young men get involved. See what it has the ability to do, because then you can market yourself better, develop yourself better with all the skills you can learn in pageantry, and it is not easy. It is hard work, but seeing it through makes it all completely worth it. Thank you, and good evening.
That was Mr. Carlos Yearwood, Mr. Barbados.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome on stage delegate number 5, Mr. St. Martin, Larry Hall.
Mr. Hall, good evening.
Good evening to everyone.
All right, I know that you had a bit of a struggle, I would say, getting here to Nevis. Now you're here and you've had this experience. Is it worth it?
I
better person at the end of the day. I thank you.
All right, all right, all right. So, Mr. St. Martin, I'm going to let you select your question, and then I'm going to read it to you twice, okay? All right, your question this evening. There are many persons who believe that to be masculine, one must not show any form of emotion. In your opinion, how can this affect the mental health of men? There are many persons who believe that to be masculine, one must not show any form of emotion. In your opinion, how does this affect the mental health of men?
Funny you ask that question, because my platform for Mr. GQ is mental health. With that being said, because of the male factor, they're being judged occasionally. They are afraid to show emotions, and this is where we are failing as a community. Because they're failing to show emotions, it tends to build anxiety, it builds depression, and it builds majority of the things where people are suffering from. So instead of them building up all of that, I feel that men should be able to express themselves how they want, just as how the ladies. Am I right? I feel so too. So it is important to express yourself, because expression is very important in life. Because I would like to deal with someone who has mental problems. With that being said, for those who are not speaking out on the mental situation that you're having with depression, anxiety, and suicidal thoughts, speak to someone. Find someone who you can trust to know your problems, because a friend indeed is a friend in need. I thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Hall. All right.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome finally delegate number 6, Mr. Antigua and Barbuda, Renor Sharp.
Mr. Sharp, good evening.
Good evening, how are you?
I'm doing well. So I heard that you're a singer. Could you give the audience some bars?
Come a little bit closer, let me hold you, baby. I will be good to you, and we can try to forget tomorrow. Let me last forever tonight.
All right, all right, all right. Okay, so you're the final contestant, so the last question is all yours. I will repeat it. In the Caribbean, women are primarily the head of the single parent household. There are, however, some men who are single parents. Do you believe that in those cases, women should have to pay child maintenance? I'll repeat. In the Caribbean, women are primarily the head of single parent households. There are, however, some men who are single parents. Do you believe that in those cases, women should have to pay child maintenance?
Well, you kind of have to put things into perspective. A woman can't pay child support if she's not alive, all right? So if the mother is absent because, well, she has died, then that's a different scenario. However, if she is alive, then of course she should pay child support. Do you understand? I mean, why should the stigma be attached wherein men have to assume certain roles, but women do not assume the same roles, and when at the end of the day, we're all striving for equality. So if you're gonna be fair and just in any cause, I do think if a mother is alive and available, she should pay child support.
All right. Thank you very much. Mr. Renor Sharp, everyone. Thank you very much, audience, for respecting the gentleman. I'm sure you got a lovely bit of information from them. Good night.
And ladies and gentlemen, The judges are judging interview on the following basis. Content, 30 points. Answer must be relevant to the question. No contradiction or redundancies. Command of language, 15 points. Appropriate sentence construction, no grammatical errors. Appropriate use of quotations and proper enunciation. And personality, 5 points. Must project confidence, poise, posture, and naturalness.